We get a little creative for the more adventurous. We have something we call the breakfast latte, which is bacon syrup mixed with maple syrup. Some people really like it, some people don't. The first thing that I heard about Open Streets was actually before we had taken over the shop. I didn't know what to expect. I didn't know what was gonna happen.
Open Streets Minneapolis is an initiative of the Minneapolis Bicycle Coalition. It takes place on a weekend, typically during the middle of the day. All you're doing is closing a street to cars and opening it up to people.
Open Streets events are catalytic events. They really help highlight the value of biking and walking in a community. Some of our biggest supporters are the businesses that line Lindale, including the gas station.
This is independently owned, and it's also locally owned too. I just live about a half a mile down. When people are driving past, you know, your store, as opposed to walking, they tend to forget and they tend to kind of generalize it and clump it all together. When they're on a bike, it kind of helps them to slow down and say, oh, well, let me see what's going on this site right here.
This is a map of the entire 10th Ward, and the Open Streets event went from 22nd Street all the way down to 42nd Street.
None of us in the city staff thought that it would ever happen. We just thought it was going to be a flop. When I took the phone call from Colin, my initial reaction was no.
We met with members of the police department, the fire department, public works, and other departments with the licensing coordinator to really talk through how can we make this possible.
I didn't know if I could get enough buy-in from the business community and the neighborhood associations.
Councilmember Tatu's office, this is Leslie.
Meg wanted to be certain that businesses and residents be notified.
So what we did was attempted to get those business owners to be part of the event.
We worked closely with all the businesses to talk about any fears that they may have had. It was important for us to be nimble and think about possible solutions.
All of the business owners said, well, if we can do a little bit of outside setup, advertising, sales displays, etc., which they normally can't do because of city code, they said we're gonna buy in.
We decided to do Latin-style street food on the patio and a live flamenco show.
Our neighbors, Twin Town, were having music outside.
What surprised me is how fast the street filled up with people, and then how long they stayed.
We estimate that about 5,000 people showed up.
It brought in a lot of new customers who had never been in the shop before. There was a line sometimes from the register all the way to the door.
The Open Streets really gave us an opportunity to take advantage of people moving at a slower pace and also to really get to see how we are different from our competition.
Double, almost triple what a normal day was like, and the sales were phenomenal.
And I was absolutely amazed at how many people stayed for how long. They wanted to stay out all day, and so that might be something we'll look at is to not only lengthen the event in terms of geographic, but also in terms of time.
As soon as it was over, it was just kind of like, all right, you know, so let's do this every Sunday. Let's do this, you know, one Sunday a month.
The more special events we have in the city, the more financial impact, the better quality of life.
So we love it. We love participating. It's a lot of fun for us, too, because it's something different. It's hard work, but it's really rewarding.
As long as there's the local officials that are willing to say, yes, we could make this work,
We've got some great businesses down Lindale.
I think it literally can be done anywhere.
The real way to build loyalty among the customers in your community is to get involved with them.
The Open Streets concept opened up not only the streets but our eyes in terms of what the residents of Minneapolis are willing to do when there is an open street.
I wish that our street was more like this all the time.
We're looking forward to the next one and see how we can be involved with the organizing of it.
Did Open Streets help us get more business in the future? I'd like to think so, but even if they didn't help us develop repeat customers, that one day was great enough that I'm more than thankful enough for that.